Welcome back to Executive Class. From Japanese food, we shift our attention to Singaporean cuisine, which despite its seeming affordability in comparison, is actually far more difficult to replicate because unlike the culinary traditions of Japan, which were much less influenced by immigrants or colonizing powers, Singapore's location and history in Asia gave it a far more eclectic tradition. So much so, even Singaporeans themselves are confused about their heritage cuisine. And if Singaporeans debate about what authentic is, imagine the confusion among tourists, or even to experienced travelers like me. So, to help me get some clarity, I visited Rempapa, a new, stylish, though unpretentious restaurant that, listen to this, offers quote-unquote authentic Singaporean heritage cuisine. Frankly, I would have dismissed Rempapa as another attempt, though a great one, to ride the current retro heritage food trend, if not for the fact that it's helmed by one of Singapore's most respected, knowledgeable, and popular advocates of heritage cuisine, Chef Damian De Silva, who continues to entertain and inform viewers and contestants with his tough love in the MasterChef Singapore edition.
So when judging a hypothetical question, a classic heritage, Singaporean heritage dish, and you were to judge it, and so what would you be looking for in terms of flavors?
I would be looking for more, first of all, if there's something to do with spice, what are the spices that I use? What are the spices that I remove, right? And like I said, it's important to know the age of the person and then to try it based on what I feel she has in her mind. Because she might not have the same knowledge that I do, and I have got to be fair as a judge, right?
But in terms of flavors, like what would you be looking for?
Most of the heritage food has got sour, sweet, bitter, salt.
And simultaneously?
Yes.
In one dish?
In one dish. A lot of us in Singapore have forgotten how to taste bitter. Because sweet is up there with everybody. That's what people want. They want sweet. And then salty. Sour and bitter are two tastes that not many people...
Which is very traditional Southeast Asian
flavors. It is, because originally it was bitter and sour.
In other words, almost exactly like what his dishes at Rempapa taste like.
All right, so I've always been curious about what Singaporean cuisine was all about, and clearly it's more than just about one ethnicity. It's a multiracial cuisine. You have Indian, you have Peranakan, you have Malay, of course, Chinese, although it's not here. And let's not forget Eurasian, always left out.
Here you go, David. So when we were growing up, we always had tamarind water because it was very cooling. There you go.
And that's also good. Tamarind everywhere.
Yes, exactly.
Although the plating at Rempapa was tweaked to appeal to the Instagram generation, the ingredients, style of cooking, and size of the servings, and most of all, the flavors, are what a local from the generation of Chef Damian's grandfather would recognize. Especially since it was his grandfather who taught him how to cook.
Granddad was an amazing cook. He used to have friends who were chefs in Chinese restaurants come to the house. And I used to do all the prep cooking while they were sitting down drinking, and I would bring the fried dishes there. I didn't think much about it, you know. Even when I asked him to teach me how to cook, you know, he just said to me, okay, I don't want you to do anything. I just want you to watch. Just watch, Damian.
Great food at home did inspire Damian to pursue a culinary career, though it was a roundabout journey back to his roots.
So I went abroad, I went to Italy, I went to Spain, I went to France, and I came back. I brought back European cuisine that I enjoyed, that I wanted to share with everybody else.
So what changed?
Well, I did it for a year, and then I sat down and I says, this is not me. You know, I love what my granddad and my grandma did. And I thought to myself, the thing that came to my mind was when my granddad asked me, why do you want to cook, Damian? Why? And I says, look, Pop, if you die, who's going to cook for me? Because what Mum knows is Peranakan. Nobody else can cook what you do. So So that's going to leave me lost, right? So I says, no, I don't want to be lost. I want to learn what you have there. And I did. I learned, but not enough. So when I, you know, when I sat down one day and I was cooking one of his dishes, and I said to myself, you know, if I don't do this, it's going to disappear. It's going to die, right?
You make it sound like heritage cuisine in Singapore is endangered. It's almost extinct. Is that the situation?
Yeah, because there are dishes out there that nobody knows or cooks anymore. Right. So it is extinct.
Which is, for a foreigner like me, a visitor, it's hard to believe, because almost every other establishment says they're heritage cuisine. So apparently that's misleading.
It is misleading, right? If you go out there and you speak to someone that's below 25 and you ask them, do you know what heritage cuisine is? The first thing that comes to mind is, oh, it's hawker cuisine. And they are not wrong,
no,
but they are not 100% right.
Food is.
Exactly, right? So for me, I look at the person first, and then I ask the person, what's your ethnicity? And how much do you know, you know, the culture and the heritage and the food of your ethnicity? And surprisingly, about 80% of the Singaporeans don't actually know.
It was about the time when Singapore began its path to rapid development, when heritage took a backseat to modernizing the economy. So with changing family structures and modern urban lifestyles, heritage cuisine was deemed no longer practical, or even possible. Such dishes required full-time cooks at home, took many hours, even days to prepare, and were made for sharing with entire families, even extended families seated together at dinner.
And nobody today wants to deal with innards because it smells, right? And you have to know how to handle them, right? So, you know, after cleaning them, you got to dice them. And you got to dice them really, really fine. And then eventually you start cooking the dish. And when you cook the dish, after you cook it, you can't eat it. You have to wait the next day for all the flavors to, you know, to come in.
To fill this void, hawker food and commercial restaurants served as a version of it, though for reasons of time and cost, a watered-down copy of those dishes cooked at home.
So if it's not heritage cuisine, what is it?
It's food that actually fed the nation. Trust me, hawker food is something that fed my father, you know, his friends, when they were working in Singapore then, right? They were just too busy. They didn't come back till 8, 9 at night. So what food did they eat? They ate hawker food. That's what they ate.
So I guess, what then is heritage food?
So heritage food was what they ate when they were at home, when they had a party.
When they had time.
Exactly. And, you know, it encompasses not just one cuisine, it encompasses five different ethnicities in Singapore. So Chinese, Malay, Indian, Peranakan, Eurasian.
It just depends on your ancestry then.
Exactly, exactly. And don't forget, the influence of the people your grandparents and your parents grew up with. So I like to say, you know, you look at one dish in Singapore, and that's mee siam. You have the Chinese mee siam, the Malay mee siam, the Indian mee siam, the Peranakan mee siam, and the Eurasian mee siam. They're the same, but different, right? And that's who we are. That's what Singapore is all about. It's all about these different cultures, and they've come together and eventually embrace each other's cultures.
Chef Damon isn't alone in his advocacy. Singapore today is experiencing a renaissance of sorts in authentic heritage cuisine, with various conservation groups documenting and preserving it, while a new generation of chefs are also trying to reimagine it in novel ways to attract younger food lovers nostalgic for their ancestors' culture.
And I think that's what makes Singapore so interesting, right?
That's what I always say, you know? This is, you know, I've always said to people that, you know, heritage, culture, is the heart of the nation. It's who we are, right? And if we lose that, we lose our soul,